Okay, I've got the giant squib mic right here, and I've got it going straight into the camera, and this is with the 5-foot cord, so I've got it fished underneath this little sweater, jacket, whatever you call it, and then it's going to the camera. And so this is my first test. After this, I'm going to hook it into an extension cable and try it that way. And then we're going to use a separate recorder, and we're going to do a clip doing it that way. So we're going to do three different options here. So this is clip one. We'll see how this goes. Okay, so now I have the giant squib mic plugged into about a 10-foot extension cable. It's a cable that I bought from Rode that is a shielded cable. It's designed for boom mics, so it's a decent quality cable. So we'll see what this sounds like now with that with it going through that cable.
The audio out of the Olympus DS2 was not usable, so I'm going to play some audio out of the Zoom 4N, H4N, and this will not be in sync, but it'll give you a sample of the audio.
And I've got the giant squid mic plugged into my H4N, and I've got the level set up to 70. And I've got it so that it records onto both channels, both the left and right channel. And so this is going to be a test. I'm going to put this up with no processing, no post-processing at all. So we're going to see A, how clean this mic is, and B, how good a job the Zoom H4N does recording it. And again, I've just got the 5-foot cord plugged right into the external mic jack on the Zoom. And I'm going to actually pause the recording and then plug in an extension cable and see how much of a difference that makes. Okay, so now I have the extension cable plugged in, the 10-foot extension cable by Rode, and we'll see if that introduces any noise to the situation. And again, we're going to put this up without any post-processing whatsoever and see exactly what kind of quality we get. So follow me, craigship.com, twitter.com/craigship.